Although populations of refugees in the countries they come from have always fluctuated and changed, the biggest source of refugees right now would be coming from the Middle East. Not even entirely all refugees, just people that they would consider people of concern. The definition of refugee is actually quite complex. You just can't consider everyone trying to leave their country a refugee. It really comes down to what countries they're coming from, reasons for leaving, whether it's war or famine or things like that. And a lot of that factors in on if they can actually legitimately be considered a refugee. And even if you are considered a refugee, it gets a lot harder. Many refugees wait many, many years before they're allowed to any country. And even past that point, really changing cultures is such a hard thing to do. Depending on where you're coming from, it may be language, or it may just be finding means of getting food or income, or finding jobs, and it really does just get harder past that point. If at all possible, I really, really wanted a professional opinion, and I was lucky enough to interview Chimmy, who coordinates staff at the Minnesota Council of Churches. What he does is he helps refugees find jobs and become self-sufficient, so he's very well versed in the subject. Chimmy said he was much more comfortable speaking away from the camera, and so that was how the entire interview was done.
America specifically, but what are some troubles when they get there, or maybe just, you know, trying to get there? What are some big struggles?
I think the biggest the trouble they face is the culture, you know, this cultural shock. Because refugees normally have been living in very crowded camps where they didn't have any exposure to any kind of technology or any kind of modern infrastructures, and when they go to a new place, adjusting to that kind of advanced society is a big trouble. Mm-hmm.
There are many, many organizations dedicated to helping refugees. One worth noting is the Refugee Council USA, or the RCUSA for short. I know they focus a lot on helping refugees coming to America. Another really big organization worth noting is the UNHCR, or the UN Refugee Agency. It is an organization aimed at helping refugees all around the world, and it's been around since the 1950s, and so definitely they've been here long enough, and they've helped tens of millions of people restart their lives, and they've made a huge impact on people worldwide. But we don't have to start worldwide. We have a lot of organizations in Minnesota more than willing to help refugees. A big one would be the International Institute of Minnesota, who largely focuses on refugee resettlement. And then for sure there's organizations like the Minnesota Council of Churches, who focus a lot on helping refugees find homes, jobs, and just giving them support in every area they need. Organization, is there any way that we can help out, or through, I don't know, it could be anything like volunteer work or anything along the lines of that? Is there any way we can, you know, really help the cause?
Yeah, our organization, all non-profit organization, depend mostly on volunteer hours and donations from our community. Mm-hmm. Of course, you know, people, college students and high school students, if they can either intern or volunteer with organization, will be really helpful.
I think what often slips our mind about refugees is that more often than not, they're not here because they want to be. They're here because they need to be, or they're here out of desperation. It really does come down to us to help them out, because they're in a situation where they're not used to the environment, they're not used to the culture, and more often than not, they're not used to the language either. And so, if possible, definitely reach out to them. There was one final message that Chimmy left with me that really made an impact. It's kind of long, and I'm going to have to ask you to bear with me, but I think it's definitely worth hearing out.
Is there anything else that you really want to just personally say?
Working in a refugee organization is really rejoicing for me, because I get to meet people from different cultural background, religious background, and get to hear a lot of stories that human being had suffered in their lifetime, and the opportunity that we get to help people in giving their hope back through, you know, employment and having their own income to help them realize the American dream is the biggest joy that you can see in the work, the kind of work we do at the, not only at the Minnesota Council of Judges. I think people who are working for the refugee resettlement anywhere in Minnesota and other states have the same joy of helping people regain their lost hope and freedom and happiness.
Nice. That's good. You know, for sure there's a lot of joys as well, but when it comes to, you know, the toughest part of the job, is there anything that's really, you know, too tough for it, or?
Well, I don't say the job is tough, but it's tough to hear the sad stories that people have gone through, you know, and getting into their shoes and looking through their perspective of what they have faced in their life is the toughest thing to hear. Mm-hmm. Heartbreaking, actually. Mm-hmm. You know, the job, I think the job that we do is the most joyful job, I think, that you can be able to do, because you get to learn so many things, you know, culture, language, everything.